Now, here's a question. Can too much calcium cause kidney stones? Well, there are some studies that show that if you're taking about 500 milligrams of calcium carbonate, which I never recommend because this is like consuming a stone or cement, that could increase the risk of kidney stones. Okay, so yes, it's a possibility. Now, the other condition is when you have hypercalcemia. That could come from many different things. One cause would be taking massive doses of vitamin D. I'm talking about over 100,000 IUs over many months. You could develop hypercalcemia, which could potentially lead to kidney stones. But the more likely cause of kidney stones is some type of dysfunction within the kidney, okay? It's kidney damage from years of maybe eating incorrectly, and your body has a difficult time of getting rid of certain things. The most common kidney stone is calcium oxalate stones. One thing that you could do if you're prone to getting kidney stones is make sure that the foods that you eat are not high in oxalates, okay? Here are some popular high oxalate foods that are also keto-friendly. Almonds, okay? So you want to avoid these. Spinach. Now, if you consume cheese at the same time you're consuming spinach, the oxalates in the spinach will bind with the calcium in your digestive tract, and it won't get absorbed into the blood and out to the kidney. So that's one way to cope with that. Also, when you steam spinach, you reduce the oxalates. Swiss chard is very high in oxalates, so you want to probably avoid that. And chocolate can also create a problem. Next thing, low citrates, okay? How do you handle that? You can either take like potassium citrate or other minerals that are in the citrate form, or you can take lemon juice. And if you're prone to kidney stones, you know, 2+ ounces of lemon juice every single day is not a bad idea. Put it in your water. And if you have a kidney stone, you probably want to take 8 ounces of lemon juice every single day, because citrate helps dissolve calcium oxalate stones. All right, next thing, which is probably the most important thing, is you want to make sure you have enough fluids. At least 2.5 liters of fluid if you're prone to kidney stones. That's simply going to keep your urine from becoming too concentrated, so you're going to make it really hard for your body to develop any stones just by doing this right here. Some people do 3 liters a day, so at least that should help you. Next thing, there are certain microbes that help dissolve oxalate stones. And there's some data that shows that stones can develop if you're missing that microbe. And they're doing research right now as I speak on giving people that microbe to help decrease the risk of stones. But it's unavailable for you to just buy commercially. However, we do know that if there's a healthy microbiome, the risk of kidney stones goes down, okay? The other thing that you want to make sure you're consuming is higher amounts of fiber, because fiber helps bind with calcium and oxalates together. So have your large salads. Of course, not the spinach or the Swiss chard. The other thing is bile. If your gallbladder is working, you have enough bile salts, this can also reduce the risk of kidney stones, because bile helps bind with calcium and oxalates as well. And some people use purified bile salts to help dissolve kidney stones. All right, so I hope that answered the question, and thank you so much for watching.
We are excited to bring you the 2020 Virtual Healthy Keto Summit this August 29th and 30th. This event will be completely online, broadcasted to you remotely, so you can attend the event from the privacy of your own home. Get ready to take your knowledge of keto and fasting to a whole new level. Learn from top experts. You'll also be able to ask the speakers questions from our Q&A panel on Saturday and Sunday. Here's a short summary of the speakers and topics this year. Author and YouTube educator Dr. Eric Berg will be presenting some fascinating information on nutritional deficiencies when doing both keto and intermittent fasting. Dr. Jeff Gerber is also coming. He is a board-certified family physician and known as Denver's Diet Doctor. He will be teaching you about the anti-aging effects of the ketogenic diet and much more. Dr. Gerber also puts on one of the largest low-carb keto conventions each year in Denver, Colorado. Author, researcher, Dr. Eric Westman will be speaking. He is the director of Duke Lifestyle Medicine Clinic and brings incredible, practical keto knowledge from working one-on-one with tens of thousands of clients. Professor Stephen Cunane of the University of Sherbrooke in Montreal, Canada, will present a live broadcast presentation from Canada, sharing cutting-edge information on the effects of ketones on the aging brain and how to use ketones to benefit cognitive function. Cynthia Thurlow, two-time TEDx speaker and nurse practitioner, will present the life-changing strategies on intermittent fasting that will blow through any barriers you may run into. We have invited Dr. Ali Alawati, an internal medicine specialist practicing in Oman in the Middle East. He will share his low-carb ketogenic strategies on the endocrine system and tell how he uses this diet in clinical practice. Ivor Cummins, author and biomechanical engineer, will bring his knowledge of the effects of the ketogenic diet on the cardiovascular system, explaining it in simple terms and presenting the latest research in coronary artery calcification testing. Dr. Nadir Ali is an interventional cardiologist who will be sharing cutting-edge information on cholesterol, LDL, and the ketogenic diet. This is a must for anyone who starts the ketogenic diet. Stephanie Person will be there. She is a keto coach, a social media influencer, and a consultant who has introduced the ketogenic diet to thousands of people around the world. She will share her most popular practical tips to take your results to the next level. Then we have Sim Lamb. He's an author, researcher, and biohacker from Estonia. As an expert in intermittent fasting and exercise, he will share some amazing research on longevity and body composition from his latest book, Metabolic Autophagy. And last but not least, due to popular demand, we are bringing back Nicholas Sakanos from Greece. His amazing story will blow you away. He will discuss his secrets he used to become the first keto intermittent fasting Ironman athlete in Europe and tell how he transformed his body. Get ready to be a part of this amazing virtual event.